So the early 2000s had a lot of anime influence in children's media. This can be seen in how children's anime got very popular in the US in the latter 90s. As such, a lot of shows then decided to take influence from Japanese culture. Teen Titans and Avatar are two shows that you could argue are anime because they match the feel of it quite well. Then you have stuff like Hi Hi Puffy Ami Yumi, Samurai Jack, and The Boondocks, which aren't anime, but you can certainly feel the Japanese influence. Hell, Puffy Ami Yumi is based on the Japanese duo of the same name. But then you have something so strange, so out there. You have Kappa Mikey. So I'll get this out the way. Kappa Mikey isn't a good show. It's not that entertaining. A couple of the jokes work, but a lot of them fall flat. I feel this comes from the fact that Kappa Mikey was originally intended for an older audience, but when it was picked up by Nicktoons, they kinda had to change a lot of the jokes to be more family friendly. You're probably sitting there right now all, "Anime games in, why are you shitting on the show? If it's so bad, why is the video called What Kappa Mikey Does Right?" Well, I'm getting to that. As bad as it is, there's genuine effort here. Certain aspects of the show do work, and even though this may go against the words of the great Terence Fletcher,
"There are no two words in the English language more harmful than good job."
I'd like to show what the creators got right when making Kappa Mikey, because hard work shouldn't go unrewarded. So here they are, starting with the Kappa Mikey opening is pretty good. The visuals are nice, and the song is pretty catchy. Wait, something sounds familiar. It can't be, that's just a coincidence. But the vocals sound similar. No way, it can't be. Oh my god, is that? Yeah, that's right. The opening song for Kappa Mikey was done by the Beat Crusaders. If you don't know who they are, they were a small Japanese band that provided a lot of vocals and music for the anime Beck. So already Kappa Mikey wins some brownie points for including an obscure foreign band that I love. It also showed me that the creators wanted to be faithful to anime, so they had a Japanese band create and perform a song for the show. The concept for Kappa Mikey is a pretty good one, as it parodies an aspect many people probably haven't noticed in Japanese media. The importation of actors. I'm sure that we have all noticed that an overwhelming majority of people that live in Japan are Asian. This means that whenever a film, TV show, or commercial requires an actor of a different ethnicity, they usually have to hire an actor from another country. The most famous examples of this are probably Jean Reno as Jacques Blanc in Onimusha 3,
"Henri, tu dors encore? Lève-toi vite, sinon tu vas être en retard à l'école."
And Tommy Lee Jones as the boss coffee guy. So in my opinion, I feel that's a cool concept for a show. And from the episodes I've seen, they seem to use it well. In fact, I probably wouldn't mind seeing this concept tackled by a different crew, one that can make the jokes much more natural than the previous team. When looking at the character designs in Kappa Mikey, I think we can all agree that they're horrible. They look like they were done by a high school student. Well, I feel like this was the intent, as a lot of anime fan art kinda looked like that at the time. Many people weren't used to the anime art style, so it resulted in some meme-worthy art. It's one of the few times that I feel a bad design was purposely chosen to create a decent joke. Besides the character designs, the choices for the voice actors were pretty interesting. You see, in voice acting, you kind of have two categories. There's voice actors that mostly do Western creations, and voice actors that mostly do anime and other foreign properties. This is kind of an important distinction, as having a lot of VAs that do North American stuff in an anime can be kind of distracting. The Final Fantasy X dub suffers hard from this. The cast includes both James Arnold Taylor and John DiMaggio. They both do a solid job, but sadly they sound weird and out of place in a Japanese game. Throughout the whole game, I kept expecting Waka to start laughing like Jake the Dog. So to avoid this problem, the main cast of Kappa Mikey is comprised of anime voice actors, some of which you might recognize. Mikey himself is played by Michael Sinterniklas, probably butchered that. He's most recognizable for playing Treyracer in Shaman King. Mitsuki is voiced by Kari Koronen, who also did Misato and Casca. Gonard probably is the most famous voice actor, being voiced by Sean Chamel. While he's done a lot, his most famous roles are probably either Goku or King Kai. All the voice actors do a pretty good job, and they seem to be bringing their A-game to the role. So basically, the cast is pretty good, and the designs, while poor, are actually intentionally poor. It kinda does give Kappa Mikey the vibe of if a weeaboo made an anime. So in conclusion, Kappa Mikey isn't a great show, but it does do some things right. The casting was great, the character designs were cleverly flawed, and that opening just kicks ass. Good job. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and don't forget to like and subscribe. And also, did you know they made a live-action guano costume? My god. Just something doesn't look right about that.